The same week I talked about Shang-Chi and the Legend of Ten Rings on Film Companion, I also get to talk about a whole series with an Asian person in the lead. Oh, it's Sandra Oh. The most bingeable series on Netflix right now. Today, we are going to be talking about The Chair, the story of an English professor at an American university who's just been made chair of her department. And the poor thing is kind of falling apart. In the mix is another professor who, while grieving a dead wife and an empty nest after his daughter has left for university, is discovering his romantic feelings for aforementioned colleague and chair. Uske alawa, there's the whole English department, most of whom are overwhelmingly white and male. The show takes a hilarious but pertinent look at that tumultuous time when paradigms are right at the precipice of shifting. When things and cultures begin to change for future generations, the people who bring these changes about and the price they have to pay to dare to question and alter the status quo. Sandra Oh is Ji-Yoon Kim, newly appointed chair. The character is of Korean descent and the writing goes out of its way to show her involvement with the Korean culture. There is a wonderful scene at a one-year-old's birthday party where Ji-Yoon is not present herself, but everyone is talking about her. Everyone knows what's going on in her life. So, matlab judi hui hai wo through her father. Ji-Yoon is in her 40s. She's also a single mother of a young adopted girl. She's the first female leader of her department. So, her life has many, many things which can go off balance with the slightest shift in weight. And what I liked about the series is how it stays away from tackling one problem per episode, which would have been the easier format to follow. Instead, all of these issues, the adopted child, the romantic association with the colleague, her professional commitments, her trying to lobby for a young black female professor, partially misguided student protests, an irate father, all of this simultaneously, each problem gets just a little bit more complicated in each episode until all of it comes to a head altogether in the finale. Outside of Sandra Oh's Ji-Yoon, frickin' Holland Taylor steals the frickin' show. And the fact that at the age of 78, she's offered roles where she's the main character, my God, she's a legend. Alright, sure, you've seen her do slapstick comedy in 2.5 Men for over 100 episodes. But watch her in another Netflix series, Hollywood, where she's delightfully nefarious. Here she plays Joan. Okay, she's a professor who might get fired if enrollment numbers in her class don't go up. Koi padh nahi raha class mein aake. So that's the character's starting point. Lekin uske baad, the show na painstakingly and refreshingly etches out her character, giving her the funniest moments, the smartest one-lines, and a character arc which gave me life. And get this, the show is created by two women, and all the writers are women, barring one. A fact I was entirely unaware of until it was time to write this review. You see now why I celebrate women telling women's stories. Women's stories are complicated because they're not the default. Life from the eyes of a mid-40s woman of color in a position of power. Who's telling these stories? A work environment as experienced by a woman in her 70s who's so accomplished at her job she has tenured. You won't get to hear or watch or normalize these stories unless the writers and makers are people with the lived experience of knowing what these lives can be and hence will be able to imagine and embellish stories which are not the norm. So I call The Chair the most bingeable show on Netflix right now because it is only 6 half-hour long episodes. So while this makes the viewing experience easy peasy lemon squeezy, one can also argue that the runtime is not nearly enough for the show to succeed in driving home all the things it is touching upon, and there are a lot, as you will find out. Maybe it's by design. Maybe they're not attempting to have any serious conversations with anybody. Maybe only they're kind of acknowledging that this is the world that we live in right now. These are the new age issues one must address. And as older generation falls more and more out of touch, this is how the world looks like. And how you're going to bridge the gap? Maybe we'll figure that out in the next season. Oh, and also there is a long and hilarious David Duchovny subplot. He even shows up playing himself. It's so fun. Watch The Chair on Netflix. And now for my favorite thing to do, relation made recommendation, but today with a bit of a twist. I've heard amazing things about Killing Eve, also starring Sandra Oh. And considering that show has been written by Her Highness Phoebe Waller-Bridge, I'm pretty certain that's what's going to be my very late but weekend watch. Have you all watched Killing Eve? Would you recommend? I do recommend subscribing to my channel though. Dekho kitna kaam kar rahi hu main, so many videos hai na. Please support. Free mein subscribe.